and for their unborn infants. So very much our patron saint of Christian families and Christian family life, the unborn expectant mothers. So this reason, a lot of midwives, people that help women to give birth, obstetricians, those are doctors that help women with birthing babies, and expectant mothers often will call upon them for help with the safe delivery of newborn, healthy newborns. So that is why it's a good friend to know. So if your mommy is looking to have another child or is having another child, ask St. Raymond to help. Ask St. Raymond to help with the birth of your sibling, that everything goes well and safe. Now, Raymond came from Portel at the Longa in España, Spain. Raymond's family were from the noble class, and his father, after his Raymond's birth, attempted to try to get Raymond to take over the family farms. But because of Raymond's great devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, he loved the Blessed Mother. And maybe more so because he lost his mother, right, before he was born. But the Blessed Mother for him was his mother. Just in the same way, really, the Blessed Mother is our mother too. Yes. So he decided that after doing the family business, to join the Mercedarian Friars, a new religious order at that time that was founded by the Blessed Virgin Mary, to ransom Christian slaves from the Muslims, who at that time had occupied much of this country of Spain. So the Mercedarians also spiritually ministered to the Christian slaves in Muslim regions. So as the Spanish territory was often recaptured, right, from the Muslims, the Muslims went back and forth to Africa. The redeeming Mercedarians, including St. Raymond Nonnatus, followed these Christian slaves into Algeria in North Africa. In fact, St. Raymond spent his entire inheritance ransoming his slaves, giving money that could be used to buy the Christian slaves, and then to set them free, to return them to their families. And in his last redemptive mission that he'd taken, he ran out of money. So what did he do? Give up? No. Did he steal? No, stealing is a sin. He decided to give himself over. So he exchanged himself for another person's freedom. Just a lot like what Jesus does for every one of us. So he was imprisoned then by the Muslims because he was telling the Muslims the truth about Jesus. And the truth is that Jesus is not just a nice guy. Jesus is not just a prophet, but Jesus is God incarnate. Amen? He became one of us so that he might come to set us free. And so Raymond, loving Jesus, he loved Mary. He loved Jesus, he loved Mary, of course. We love Mary, actually loving Jesus more. A competition, dear friends, we can love more than one person at a time, right? Yes. So, in telling the truth about Jesus, the Muslims decided, well, you know, we need to shut this guy up. He's talking too much, and we don't like what he's saying. So they decided to pierce his lips with a red hot poker, and to shut his mouth with an iron padlock to keep him from talking and from preaching and talking about Jesus. Some people today may not do that with a padlock, but they can shame us or bully us into being quiet about Jesus and our faith in the one who loves us and the death and the resurrection. We should not allow that to stop us from telling people about Jesus. Jesus, who is love, true love, real love. And although Raymond was in this horrible situation for a number of months, it hurt to have this padlock. It was a piercing that he didn't want, right? And they got to open it up to give him food, and then put the padlock back on, and it was horrible, right? But he endured it bravely, and the mercenaries came back with some money to get him back and set him free. Raymond was just so known for his make sure that Bobby and Daddy and Grandpa, or Grandpa, and you yourself call the church for a priest to come and visit. These are important things that we do to help us on our journey, not throughout life, but also generalizing. So it's said, this is they couldn't find a priest in the middle of nowhere where they were, that they prayed along the same way with the angels. Angels bearing the Mercedarian heaven, our beautiful one in heaven, came along from heaven with Jesus himself and gave St. Raymond Holy Communion miraculously. And that's why often the images of them have them holding a monstrance. Do you guys know what a monstrance is? Not sisters, students. What's a monstrance? Have you ever heard that word, monstrance? You know what that is? No? Okay, I should. Have you seen this before?
Yes.
What do we normally put inside the monstrance? Yes. Yes. Communion, right? Bread is the consecrated, which is who? Jesus, right? We put Jesus in the monstrance. So oftentimes, pictures are used in the spirit that are holding the monstrance because of Jesus.
And for the salvation